My name Wale, and I came to get it, came to get it.
All right, welcome back. He once worked to some of the toughest homicide cases in Washington, D.C., but these days, former Detective Mitch Cradle has turned to a different career path. He's the author of two books, and now he's the author and director of a new movie called Boss, which tells the story of life on the streets in D.C. through the eyes of the people who lived it. Check it out.
Get out of the car. For what? Get out of the car for what, man?
Man, can I get you to step out the vehicle?
They said he left like 6 hours ago. Should have been here by now.
You think they set him up?
Nah, something else, sir.
What about the drugs?
You want to take a package and leave with the money. That's it. Ladies, there's nothing to worry about. One of the guys will be with you always.
It should be a meeting with my attorney.
Oh, so you do have something to hide.
Some murder. I got my own problems. I ain't got time to be dealing with this.
All right, Detective Cradle joins us now live to talk more about the movie and where you can see it. Thank you for coming in this morning.
Thanks.
Appreciate your time. So let's start off. You're going to have a limited showing of this starting out, and we're going to put that information on the screen right now so everybody can see where they go see the movie.
Sure. This Sunday, January the 10th, we'll be at the Howard Theater. It's the first movie ever played at the Howard Theater, so I'm honored to have my film play there.
All right, so let's talk about what the movie's about. But tell us about the movie Boss.
Well, Boss is a fictional film about a prostitute who came across a shipment of narcotics that, of course, did not belong to her. And instead of her giving it to the person who it belonged to, was a notorious street guy by the name of Hakeem. She kept it and gave it to her madam, and her madam sells it, and cannot find drugs on the street to realize she has it, and then everything just go crazy.
Now, you were a D.C. police officer for how many years?
29.
29 years on the streets of Washington, D.C. Where did you draw the inspiration for this movie?
Well, this particular movie, I was inspired by a good friend of mine who passed away back in 2005. Mm-hmm. She was a D.C. street legend, which everybody know. Her name was Maddie Johnson. Everybody called her Sweet Maddie.
Mm-hmm.
And it was instrumental to me to make this first film thinking of her because she was instrumental in me becoming a good homicide detective. We met back in 1991 when I was a rookie homicide detective, and I learned the streets from her because, I mean, I grew up in D.C., but I wasn't the type of person who hung out on the streets all the time. But just meeting her helped me connect with a lot of people on the streets, and I said when I make my first film, most definitely want to dedicate it to her.
Was it difficult making your first film and getting funding, and because you did a lot of the stuff yourself?
I did basically everything except with the help of Malakon Production. I did everything.
Right. Was that hard?
It was difficult. I had to write it first. Then I had to select the cast. I didn't have a casting director. And, I wanted to reach out to some named people. I said, well, with no budget, I can't hire anyone.
Right,
so
right.
I just reached out to people in the community where I've worked for years. And them people, they volunteered to play the roles.
Right. When people see this movie, what do you hope they take away from it?
I want them to take away from it more than just the film itself. I want them to look at me as a filmmaker here in D.C., mm-hmm. as a police officer in D.C. I want them to look at the police community relations of how we can get along and do things. I want them just to look at that here in D.C., we can make films. We're so used to watching films made in New York, mm-hmm. Atlanta, L.A., and I want to bring that Hollywood experience here in D.C.
Is that why you decided to do this and do this yourself and use your experiences, the things that you know about? Is that why you decided to do this, to put that message out there?
Yes, I want everything I just mentioned, I want to put that complete message out there. But most important, I want to show people in other cities that we can do that here in D.C. We don't have the budgets that they have in other major cities, but if we keep working as independent filmmakers, I'm quite sure one day we will get it.
How close to reality is the story in this film, or some of the characters, or some of the things that happened in this film? Any of that close to reality at all, or is completely fictional?
The story is fictional,
mm-hmm.
but the events are real. Those things happen, and just by working on the streets in D.C. for years, I mean, I've seen those things happen, so I was able to put it together in a fictional story. Because,
right.
of course, being in the police department, I wasn't allowed to tell non-fictional stories.
Right.
So I had to create fictional stories, and that's the path I'm going to go for a while.
Right. And you've also done two books?
Yes.
You've done two books. You got any plans to do any more books?
Yes, I have one book that I've, matter of fact, I finished. It's a it's a non-fiction. It's called Homicide Me, Living Black and Blue.
Mm-hmm.
It's a real good detailed story about my life as a homicide detective.
Right.
and I'm going to wait before I publish it. I'm not ready to publish it yet.
You were a police officer for nearly 30 years in Washington, D.C. I'm sure you've seen a lot of different things. When you see what's going on right now in society with the, let's just call it an adversarial relationship in some places between the police and the community, what is your reaction to that?
Well, my reaction to it is that I think it needs to be much better than what it is. Mm-hmm. And I say that because even before I joined the police department, I was doing community work.
Right.
And even as a rookie, I continue to do community work. So even while I'm investigating homicides, sex cases, robberies, whatever, I'm still doing community work in the neighborhoods where a lot of things are going on. So if the gap, if that bridge and that gap can be closed in with some of the things that I've done and some of the things, first of all, I'm not the only police officer that do community service.
Right.
There are a lot of other police officers that coach, mentor, and if more police officers do that, I believe that the gap will be. The community would trust a great deal of them the way they trust me.
Right. Any of those issues that we're dealing with today in your movie?
No.
Not that, all right.
No, I'm not going to deal with those. Maybe in another movie.
Maybe in the next
not
movie.
Not this one.
Right, gotcha, okay. Thank you very much for coming in this morning. Appreciate your time. The location, right there on your screen, where you can go and see Boss.
Howard Theater.
Yeah. Sunday, 6:30, doors open at 5 p.m. You see the ticket prices right there on the screen. The movie is called Boss. This is former police officer Mitch Cradle from right here in Washington, D.C. Thank you for your time. Let's go back over you to the beautiful couch.
All right, thanks, guys.
That was for your local filmmakers. Yeah. A lot of workers into trying to do something like that. Good luck to them. Time right now is 9:20. Coming up a little bit later, decorations coming down. Now you're...